Hi, welcome back to the MapTiler channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a vintage map using MapTiler Customize. So what makes a map vintage? I think there are three key things. A vintage color palette with those faded colors, serif fonts, and using pattern fills, which aren't seen as much today as they used to be. Make sure you stay to the end because the patterns we use today really make the map pop. First, I'll select one of the standard maps provided in MapTiler Cloud. I'm going with Basic Light, a simple style that's easy to add more detail to. In Quick Edits, I'll change the background color to be browner, giving that vintage aged look where time has turned the paper from white to sepia. Now, let's check which layers are in the basic map. I'll turn some off to simplify the styling, but this is where you can also add layers if you need them in your map. When you're done with that, we can look at customizing the feature colors. Before you start, I recommend creating a color palette and deciding which will work for the different layers. I recommend starting at street level, around zoom level 16, and then zooming out and adjusting the colors where needed. To help make the map easy to understand at a glance, it is good to use shades of colors that the features have in real life, or that people strongly associate with them. For example, using blue tones for water. If you want to use the same colors as me, just follow the link in the description below. Vintage maps typically have serif fonts, traditional typefaces that were commonly used in the past. In MapTiler Customize, you can choose from multiple serif font families. Sinsel, Libre Baskerville, Merriweather, Noto Serif, PT Serif, and Volcorn. I'll use Merriweather as the main font on this map. Now let's polish it. I'll use the Bulk Edit to adjust the outline and change its color to blend in with the map. I'd like to have city labels with uppercase letters. You can set this in the advanced text properties. There's also the option to set them to lowercase, but that isn't good for place names. If you're finding this video helpful so far, don't forget to like it and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the next tutorial. I also want to add icons to the labels. This helps you locate the feature more precisely, and it also gives us the chance to give the map another decorative element we can use to extend the vintage feel. Many old maps are also easily recognizable by their paper texture and patina. This feeling can be mimicked by creating an SVG seamless dot pattern designed in graphics software like Inkscape. The key with the pattern is not to make all the dots the same. You can start from perfectly symmetrical dots and then distort them randomly. Remember, the background needs to be transparent. So, let's upload the icon set. I have prepared them in an SVG, which is a vector format. Two marker icons and a pattern. Compress all the files into one zip and upload it to your map. To have the icons rasterized, I toggled off the Convert to Customizable Icons SDF Sprite option. Now, let's add the star for country labels and adjust its position. I like to have the icon on the actual point and adjust the label text next to it. This can easily be done with the translate option. And I'll do the same with the dot icon for city labels. I think this dot's too big, so let's make it a bit smaller. Okay, let's add the pattern. I'll create two, one for land and one for sea. Because I want to use it as an overlay, I'll create a new layer just for the pattern. Simply select the pattern and change the opacity to 10%. And again, the same for water. Let me delete the custom opacity. I think the pattern is a bit more visible on the water, so let's just change that to 8% opacity. And that's it! A great looking map with a vintage style you could use to highlight local history. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe for more tutorials, and let us know what other styles you'd like us to make videos for in the comments below. Bye for now!